In this lesson, I'm going to show you how you can assume a role using the command line interface. Now, back in the IAM management console, we're going to go to users and Paul. And what I want to do is I'm actually just going to remove these managed policies. So I'm going to detach the Amazon EC2 full access. I'm also going to detach the S3 full access. So that means Paul no longer has permissions. So what Paul's going to do is use the CLI to actually assume a role. So what I then want to do is go to roles, come down to EC2 full access. This is the role that Paul's going to assume, just like when we did it in the management console in a previous lesson. In this case, he's going to assume the role and it's going to have EC2 full access, just as before. Now, what I need is the ARN of the role. So I'm copying that to my clipboard. You'll then find in the course download that in the code directory, IAM, we have this profile ec2fullaccess.config file. And what we need to do here is paste the ARN of our role. So mine has already been done. So make sure you've got the correct ARN with your account number and your role name. We'll then copy this to our clipboards. So I copy that to my clipboard. And I'm going to show this demonstration on Windows. Remember, on Windows, the location of the config and credentials files is users, administrator, and .aws. Now, just to prove that I don't have access, I'm going to run AWS EC2 and then describe instances. Hit enter, and it tells me I'm not authorized to perform this operation. So what I need to do is open up the config file. I'm going to open it with Notepad, click OK. And in here, what we're going to do is paste in that information. So what we have is we have a default profile. Now, when we run the AWS commands, it's going to run as the default profile. And all that we have in here is the region US East 1. Now, in this case, it then uses the credentials that are in the credentials file. But what we're doing now is we're specifying another profile, which is EC2-full-access. When this profile is used, and it's something that we specify on the command line, it's going to assume the role that has this role ARN. It's not using the credentials in the credentials file. So that's all I need to do there. I can click on save. I can come back and rerun the command, but this time I'm going to type --profile, and then I'm going to copy this name here. So this is the name of the profile, and then simply paste that in. Hit enter, and now I actually get a response. Now I have instances running so I can see information about those instances. If you don't have any instances, then what you'll find is you just don't get an error message. Let's also add S3 permissions now to the role, not to Paul, and let's see if we can run some commands using S3. So back under roles, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to add permissions, attach policies, type in S3, choose the S3 full access, attach, and that's been attached. Now, if I come back and I run AWS S3 LS, then I'm not going to be able to run this command. It's access denied as Paul. But if I add the profile information, then it should work. So let's hit enter again. And this time I don't get a response. So it's really easy to assume roles from the command line. Now, we can also add additional profiles with different credentials if we want to as well. So for example, I can run AWS configure. This time, I'm going to put in --profile, Neil. So I'm going to create my own profile, hit enter, and it's going to ask me for my access key ID and secret access key. So back in IAM, I'm going to generate some security credentials for my account. I already have an access key, but I'm going to create a new one just to show you how to do it again. Let's copy my access key ID, paste that in. I now need the secret access key. So let's copy this to my clipboard, paste that in. I'm going to select the US East 1 region again as my default region. And that's the command completed. So now I can run commands as myself. So again, I can run AWS S3 LS. And this time I can choose --profile, Neil. And I get a response using my particular profile. Now, what you'll see now, if I just close this file so that I can refresh it, is when I go into the config file, we have another profile for Neil with US East 1. And then if we go into credentials, we'll now see two sets of credentials. So we have the default credentials, which in this case is Paul, and then we have the credentials for the Neil user as well.